Students, today we are going to study the image form techniques, and this is the chapter number 4 of DIB. The image transformation transform plays a fundamental role in the image processing. As working with the transform of an image instead of image itself make you the more insight into the properties of the image. The two-dimensional transform are applied to the image enhancement, restoration, encoding, and description. Next, unitary transform. The first one is the one-dimensional signal. For one-dimensional sequence, suppose f of x, where x is in between 0 to n minus 1, represented as a vector of f of that is it f. Point starts from f of 0 to n minus 1 and its transform, that is the row element will be converted into the column element, that is nothing but the transformation of a size n. Transformation may be written as a g is equal to t into f, that is g of u is equal to summation of x is equal to 0 to n minus 1 t of u of x f of x for u is in between 0 to n minus 1, where g of u is the transform or transformation of f of x, and t of ux is called as a forward transformation kernel, that is g is equal to t into u, t is the transformation function and t of ux is called as a forward transformation kernel. And simply inverse transform relation is nothing but from this factor you will get the f of x, that is summation of u is equal to 0 to n minus 1 I of x of u into g of u, where x is in between 0 to n minus 1, or written in the matrix form f is equal to I into g, that equal to inverse transform into the g, where I of x u is called as the inverse transformation kernel, t of u of x is called as a forward transformation kernel, and I of u of x is called as the inverse transformation kernel, that is I is equal to inverse transform or t transformation, that is complex transformation. The matrix T is called unitary, and the transformation is called unitary as well. Why? Because the columns, that is number of rows n by n, n into n, unitary matrix are orthogonal, and therefore the complete set of basic vector in the n dimensional vector space. So this is one dimensional signal. So in this case, f is equal to t complex transform that into g, that is f of x is equal to summation n is u is equal to 0 to n minus 1 complex t of u of x into g. That is this parameter, that is the t complex of transformation is the vector, that is t of u into 0, second factor is or parameter is u of 1 up to u of n minus 1 transformation is called as a basic vector of the t. Next is the two-dimensional signal, which is for the image. As one-dimensional signal is represented by an orthogonal set of basic vector, an image can also expand it in terms of the discrete set of basic arrays called as a basic image through the two-dimensional transform. And it can be given for the n by n image, f of x, y is the forward and reverse transform are given as a u of g of u v is equal to, that is transformed image is equal to summation x is equal to 0 to n minus 1 y is equal to 0 to n minus 1 t of u v x y into f of x y, where f of x y is the inverse of two dimensional signal image, that is u is equal to 0 to n minus 1 v is equal to 0 to n minus 1 I of x y u v g of u v, where t of u v x y and I of x y u v are called as a forward and inverse transformation kernels respectively. The forward kernel is said to be separable if t of u v x y is equal to t1 of u x into t2 of t1 of u y. The same commands are valid for the inverse kernel. The kernel t of u, v, x, y of the image transform is separable and symmetric, then the transform g of u v is equal to summation x is equal to 0 to n minus 1 y is equal to 0 to n minus 1 t of u v x y into f of x y is equal to inverse of its, that is summation x is equal to 0 to n minus 1 y is equal to 0 to n minus 1 t1 u of u into x t1 u into u of y f of x y can be written in the matrix form. That is, this is the g of u v can be converted to the g. This first term is converted into t1 into f into t2 into t1 into r, where f is the original image of size n by n, t1 is an n by n transformation matrix with the element t1 of I into j. In addition, t1 is unitary matrix, then transformation called the separable unitary, and original image is recovered through the relationship f is equal to t1 complex of t into g into t1 complex. Next, the fundamental properties of the same unitary transform. The first property is the property of energy preservation, that is unitary transformation g is equal to t into f, and it is easily proved that modulus of g square is equal to modulus of f square. Thus, the unitary transformation preserves the signal energy. This property is called as the energy preservation property, where signal can be preserved. So we can call it as an energy preservation property. This means that every unitary transformation is simply a rotation of the vector f in the n-dimensional vector space. For the 2D case, energy preservation property can be written in this way. That is, modulus of summation of 0 to x, x is equal to 0 to n minus 1, y is equal to 0 to n minus 1, modulus of f of x y square is equal to g of u v square, that is the original image is equal to transformed image. Next, the property of energy compactation. The most of unitary transformation pack a large fraction of energy of the image into the relatively few of the transform coefficient. This means that the relative few of the transform coefficients have the significant values, and these are the coefficients that are close to the origin, that is a simple index coefficient. And this this property is useful for the compression purpose or image compression purpose. Next is the two-dimensional Fourier transform, that is 2D Fourier transform. The Fourier transform is extended up to the function of f of xy of two variables. If f of xy is a continuous and integral integral and f of uv is integrable, for the following Fourier transform pair will be f of uv is equal to integration from 0 to infinity to, and f of xy is equal to e raised to minus j 2 pi ux plus vy dx dy. That is, f of xy is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square integration, double integration f of u v e raised to positive coefficient e raised to j 2 pi u x plus u v du dy. F of u v is the complex valued function of two real frequency variable u comma v, and hence it can be written as the f of u v is equal to r of u v plus complex variable of the I of u v. The amplitude spectrum and phase spectrum, that is R of UV is amplitude and J of UV is the phase spectrum respectively, are defined as the F of UV is equal to under root of R square plus R square, that is the real part square plus imaginary part square, that is the amplitude, and phase will be tan inverse of imaginary divided by real, that is tan inverse of I of UV divided by R of UV, where P of u v is equal to modulus of f of u v bracket square mod function square, that is equal to r of u v square plus u of u v square. So second one is the discrete space and continuous frequency. For discrete sequence, f of x y is of infinite duration, we can define as a 2D space Fourier pair as follows. That is, f of u v is equal to summation minus infinity to infinity, second function y of, that is the second variable, y is equal to minus infinity to infinity f of xy e raised to minus j of xu plus vy, and the Fourier transform f of x y is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square integration of u is equal to minus pi to the pi, v is equal to minus pi to the pi, f of u v into e raised to j x u plus v y du dv, where f of u v is again complex valued function of two real variable frequency variables u v and the periodic with the 2 pi into 2 pi. That is say f of u v is equal to f of u plus 2 pi comma v. That is that signal will repeat after this same interval. So it is a periodic. The Fourier transform f of x y is set to the convergence uniformly when f of u v is a finite with this formula. That is limit n1 tends to infinity, n2 tends to infinity, summations for n1 into f of x y e raised to minus j x u plus v y is equal to f of u v for all u v. When the Fourier transform of f of x y converges uniformly, the f of u v is an analytic function and is infinitely differentiable with respect to u and v. Next, discrete space and discrete frequency. The two-dimensional discrete Fourier transform 2D DFT is if f of x y is m by n array such as that obtained by the sampling a continuous function of two-dimensional at a dimensions m and n on a rectangular grid, then its two-dimensional discrete Fourier transform is given by, so you already studied in the DSP, that is f of u is equal to 1 by n summation x is equal to 0 to n minus 1 y is equal to 0 to n minus 1 f of x y e raised to minus j 2 pi of u x plus Vy divided by n, where u is from 0 to n minus m minus 1 and v is from 0 to n minus 1, and IDFT will be inverse of this, that is f of xy is equal to summation u is equal to 0 to m minus 1, v is equal to 0 to n minus 1, f of uv into e raised to j 2 pi ux by m plus Vy by n. So when m is equal to n, so the formula will be straightforward. So it is a straightforward proof that the two-dimensional DFT, that is a discrete Fourier transform, is separable, symmetric and unitary. Next, properties of 2D DFT. So already we studied these properties into the DSP. The most of them are straightforward extension property of 1D Fourier transform. First one is the completeness, that is f is equal to c f tends to c raised to n is equal to c raised to n, that is discrete Fourier transform is invertible linear transformation. C is denoting the set of complex number, and in other words, for any n is greater than 0, the n dimensional complex vector has a DFT and an IDFT which are in true n dimensional complex vector. Next, orthogonality. So vector e raised to 2 pi I k n divided by n is the complex function orthogonal basis that is a Tweedle factor set of n dimensional complex vectors. So you already studied that the Tweedle factor in DSP, which is summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 into e raised to 2 pi k I k n divided by n into e raised to minus j or I 2 pi k n divided by n. So this is the delta of kk, and this is the orthogonal condition can be used to derive the formula for the IDFT from the definition of the DFT, and it is equivalent to the unitary property. Parseval's theorem, so it is defined in this way: summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n complex of y of n is equal to 1 by n summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k, that is the DFT of x of n, and y of k is the DFT of the y of n complex, where the star denotes the complex conjugate, and in this case that is summation n is equal to, the theorem will be the n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 modulus of x of n bracket square is equal to 1 by n, k is equal to 1 to n minus 1 modulus of x of k. So these theorems are equivalent to the unitary condition. Next one is the periodicity, that is the DFT is the periodic extension of the signal with the period n, and this can be defined as a x of k plus 1 is equal to, by the definition, summation n is equal to n minus 1 with the period of plus n. So it can be x of k. So it can be, similarly, extension can be evaluated for IDFT formula. Next, shift theorem, that is your signal shifted with the some time period, that is multiplying x of n by linear phase e raised to 2 pi I n divided by n for the some integer m corresponds to the circular shift of the output x of k. So this is the shift theorem. Next is the circular convolution. Circular convolution for the continuous and discrete time Fourier transform indicates the convolution of two indefinite sequence can be obtained as the inverse transform of the product of the initial transform with the sequence and transform of the length n. Next is the convolution duality theorem. So it can be defined in this way. So all these properties are done into the DSP. Next, unitary DFT. So this is the Tweedl factor matrix, where Tweedl factor W of n is equal to e raised to minus 2 pi I divided by n. And primitive nth root of the unity will be inverse of above matrix will be F inverse is equal to 1 by n F inverse or M F complex. The unitary normalization constant is the 1 by square root of n. And the DFT becomes unitary transformation defined by the unitary matrix, that is U is equal to F divided by under root of N, that is U inverse is equal to complex of U, that is delta function of U is equal to 1. Next, in the delta function is determinant function, det function is determinant function, and the determinant is the product of eigenvalues, and which is always plus minus 1 or plus minus r, which is described in this slide. The real vector space and unitary transformation can be thought as simply rigid rotation of the coordinate system, and all properties of the rigid rotation can be found in the unitary DFT. So this is the Parseval's theorem can be proved in this way. Next one, the inverse DFT, that is IDFT in terms of the DFT. If Fourier inverse Fourier transform of x of n is equal to Fourier transform of x of n minus n divided by n, so n is the modulus, interpreted modulo n, and n is from 0, and x of n minus 0 is equal to x of 0. So the conjugate output will be F inverse of x is equal to complex of f of x divided by n. The variant of this conjugate trick, which is sometimes preferable because it is no modification of the data values and it involves the swapping real and imaginary parts. So in this way we can define the IDFT. This is the first method of defining the IDFT in terms of the DFT. This is the second method by modulos using modulus. This is the third method by using the swap method of swapping of real and imaginary parts. So f inverse of x is equal to swap of f of swap of x divided by n. Next one is the real input DFT. So suppose x of 0 to x of n minus 1 are the real numbers, and the practical applications of the DFT obeys the symmetry property. That is, x of k is equal to x of complex of x of n minus k, and the n denotes the interpreted modulo n. The DFT output for the real input is the half redundant, and one obtains the complete information by looking roughly half of the output. So the there are n non-redundant real numbers in the first half plus Nyquist element of the complex output x. The using the ruler's formula or identity, interpolating trigonometric polynomial can be interpreted as the sum of sine and cosine function. Next, the importance of the phase in the 2D DFT, that is, it is used in the image reconstruction from the amplitude and phase only. So it can be f of uv is equal to approximately equal to f of xy, this is the original image, with multiplied, that is f of uv multiplied by the this theta function. So straightforward signal synthesis Fourier transform phase f phi of uv alone and captures the intelligibility of the original image f of xy. So this is up to the part of the DFT. So in next session we will study the FFT required for the image transformation. Thank you.